We now discuss the solution of a problem from the section Linear Algebra. The given problem is based on the concept of inner product, and this question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test, the exam held on 30th November 2020. And the present question is from the section B. The problem is, which of the following is an inner product on the vector space of all real valued continuous functions on the closed and bounded interval 0, 1? Options. Option 1, the bracket f, g is equal to mod integral 0 to 1 ft gt dt. Option 2 is bracket f, g is equal to integral 0 to 1 mod of f of t into g of t dt. Option 3, bracket f, g is equal to f of 0 into g of 0 plus f of 1 into g of 1. Option 4, bracket f, g is equal to integral 0 to 1 f of t g of t dt. We'll now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. We recall the definition of the inner product. Let V over R, where R is the set of all real numbers in the field of real numbers, let V over R be a vector space over a field R. A function phi from V cross V to R denoted by phi of x comma y is equal to bracket x comma y is said to be an inner product on V if the following conditions are satisfied. For all x, y, z belongs to the vector space V and alpha, beta belongs to the scalars, the field of real numbers, the following conditions are satisfied. Condition 1, bracket of x comma y is equal to bracket of y comma x. This is called the symmetry property. And this is written as bracket of x comma y is equal to bracket of y comma x when the field is the field of real numbers. If the field is the field of complex numbers, then it becomes the inner product, the bracket of x comma y is equal to bar conjugate of the bracket of y comma x. Condition 2, bracket alpha x comma y is equal to alpha times bracket x comma y. This is called homogeneity. The third property, bracket of x plus y comma z is equal to bracket of x comma y plus bracket of y comma z, and this is called additivity. Condition 4, bracket of x comma x greater than or equal to 0 and bracket of x comma x is equal to 0 if and only if x is equal to 0, and this is called the positivity. Let's now check these conditions for the given definitions. Now this is our example solution. We have V is equal to C bracket 0 comma 1. It is denoted by this. C bracket 0 comma 1 is the vector space of continuous, C stands for continuous real valued functions defined on the closed and bounded interval 0 to 1. And it is a vector space over the field of real numbers. It is a standard exercise in our MSc classes. Bracket of f comma g is equal to integral 0 to 1 f of t g of t dt for all f g belongs to V defines an inner product on V. Verify the conditions of the inner product and find out that it is the, it defines an inner product. It is left to you. Therefore, our answer is the option 4 is true. However, we rule out the other possibilities in the subsequent sections. Option 1, bracket f comma g is equal to mod of integral 0 to 1 f of t g t dt. Now, for alpha belongs to R, we have bracket alpha f comma g, by our definition will be wherever there is f of t, substitute alpha f t. Then you will get mod of integral 0 to 1 alpha f of t g of t dt. And alpha comes out of the integral. So alpha time mod of alpha times integral 0 to 1 f of t g t dt. And alpha comes out of the modulus mod alpha into integral 0 to 1 f of t g t dt. And this mod of this is the bracket f comma g. So mod of alpha into bracket f comma g. Now bracket alpha f comma g is equal to alpha times bracket f comma g. This is the condition. This and in our case, in this situation, this will be equal if and only if alpha is equal to mod alpha. That is, alpha is positive. But from the set of real numbers, the alpha comes, alpha can be even negative also. If alpha takes the negative values, then it fails. So, thus, the bracket alpha f comma g is equal to alpha times f comma g. If you want to have this condition, then alpha must be equal to mod alpha. And this will fail if alpha is negative. Therefore, the option 1, that is this bracket of f comma g, does not define an inner product. Therefore, the option 1 is not true. Now let's go to the option 2. The bracket f comma g is equal to integral 0 to 1 mod of f t g t dt. And the argument what we have put forth in the case of the option 1 is still true here. Let's see. For alpha belongs to R, we have bracket of alpha f comma g is equal to integral 0 to 1 mod of alpha times f of t g of t dt. And this under the integral sign, it will come out as mod alpha and ultimately come out of the integral also. And that will be equal to integral 0 to 1 mod alpha into mod of f of t g of t dt, and of integral of 0 to 1 mod alpha times the function will be mod alpha times the integral 0 to 1 that function. So mod alpha into mod of integral 0 to 1 f of t g t dt, and this is the bracket f comma g. So mod of alpha into bracket f comma g. And this is to satisfy that condition. Then alpha f comma g must be equal to alpha times f comma g for all alpha belongs to R. And this will be true. This will be true if and only if alpha is equal to mod alpha when alpha is positive. And when alpha is negative, this fails. Thus, the bracket alpha f comma g is equal to alpha times f comma g fails if alpha is negative. Therefore, the definition that is given in option 2 does not define an inner product. The option 2 is not true. So we are left with the other condition. The condition is 3. Bracket f comma g is equal to the value of f of 0 into g of 0 plus f of 1 into g of 1. To say that this does not define an inner product, we give a counter example. The famous example is let f of x is equal to x times 1 minus x. And clearly, x is a continuous function, 1 minus x is a continuous function, the product is a continuous function, therefore f of x belongs to the space vector space C0, 1. First note that f is not the 0 function. Why? Because f of x is equal to x times 1 minus x is not 0 when x is not 0 and x is not 1. Therefore, it is not a 0 function. Now, f comma f, that is the inner, that is the bracket f comma f is equal to, by definition, f is, g is equal to f we have taken, wherever there is g, you write f, f of 0 into f of 0 plus f of 1 into f of 1 is 0. Why? Because f of 0 is 0 and f of 1 is also 0. So, where f is not a 0 function. So, it violates the condition, the bracket f comma f is 0 if and only if f is the 0 function. Because f is not a 0 function, it violates that condition. So, therefore, the definition that is given in option 3 does not define an inner product. Thus, the option 3 is not true and our answer is option 4 is true, which we have already seen. That is a standard exercise in our linear algebra course, and you have to verify those conditions and convince. So, with this, the discussion of the solution of the problem from the section linear algebra, which involves the concept of the inner product, is complete. And I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out some more problems related to inner product and inner product spaces, and they will be important in the point of view of the CSIR NET examination. I wish you all the best. Thank you.